Welcome to Mondays with the Mayor. March is Mental Health Month, and we're out here at Coronado High School to talk to Kana Love about the Hope Squad and the important work that's being done across the community, but certainly work that she's very involved in. Kana?
Thank you so much for having me, Mayor March. I'm happy to be here.
Wonderful. Can you tell us a little bit about the Hope Squad here at Coronado?
Of course. So Hope Squad stands for Hold On, Persuade, and Empower. We are a group of people who are dedicated to helping other students in our school with mental health, with their mental health struggles. We're helping to reduce the mental health stigma. During this time especially, as everything is online, it's very hard for students to connect emotionally and physically, and it takes a toll on our mental health. So having the Hope Squad, even though it's online, is a wonderful way for us to log in and to just see each other's faces, interact with each other. We often do cahoots, which are super fun. We do trivia questions, and we honestly just connect and get to know each other a lot.
What sorts of signs do you look for when you're working with other young people? I know here you have a physical location at Coronado, but as you're working online, you probably have to look at things a little differently as well.
For sure. Yeah, a lot of question asking, just checking in, especially with my friends. It's really important to check in with my friends. One of the special things we have about Hope Squad is QPR. It stands for Question, Persuade, and Refer. So it's just the starting one with question. It's important to check in with your friends, ask questions, see if they're doing well, be bold. And you can persuade them to seek help if they are in a situation that is a depressing situation, and we can refer them to people who are able to help them.
Wonderful. So Kana, thank you so much for joining us today and talking about the Hope Squad and the important work that's being done across our community and reaching out to young people who may need someone to talk to or to reach out to deal with challenges. And across the community at the school district, there's a website called Safe Voice that young people can reach out to with the school district. And then also adults who need to talk to someone can certainly dial 211.